Hello and welcome. Today we are going to start with our chapter, Parties and the Party Systems in India. This is the fourth chapter of book number 2, and this is the latest added chapter in our syllabus. Some parts of lesson number 2, Era of One Party Dominance, has been added in this chapter, and some parts of Challenges to and Restoration of the Congress System has been added in this chapter. Starting from CBSE, if we start, CBSE has not provided with any material till now. Your books are going to come by November or December. But till now, there should be some knowledge with you so that you can prepare well for the papers. So political, in the beginning we will do what is the meaning. Some parts you have done in 10th class also. Political parties, its meaning we will do in the first instance. You know that a political party, it's a group of people who come together to contest election and hold power in the government. Wo log jo elections ladne ke liye ikatthe hote hain aur government mein power ko prapt karne ke liye ikatthe hote hain, and they agree on some policies and programs for the society with a view to promoting the collective good for the welfare of the common beings, human beings. They work and they have some common policies and programs. So what were the main components of a political party? A political party has three components. First is leaders, second is active members, and third one is followers. Kuch leaders hone chahiye. Aapko pata hai har political party mein ye leaders ke saath saath kuch members bhi hote hain. एक्टिव मेंबर्स होते हैं जो सब पार्टी का सारा कामकाज, फंड्स वगैरह देखते हैं और सारी एक्टिविटीज वो करते हैं, और फॉलोवर्स आर मस्ट, ये वो लोग हैं जो कि एक पर्टिकुलर पार्टी को फॉलो करते हैं. व्हाट आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ अ पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज? पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज दे कंटेस्ट द इलेक्शंस इन द जनरल इलेक्शंस आफ्टर एवरी 5 years और व्हेनेवर द नीड इज देयर. दे यूज्ड टू ऑर्गेनाइज द इलेक्शन एंड फाइट फॉर द इलेक्शन. दे कंटेस्ट द इलेक्शन. Moreover, on various programs and policies are put forward by political parties only for the well-being of the citizens. When these political parties, they form the government, they are an important person in making the laws. They form the laws in the lawmaking procedure. The various MPs, they participate in at state level. Various MLAs, they participate in making of the laws. They form and run the government after getting the majority. After getting the majority, these political parties, they form the government and they also run the government at center level and at state level. They also play the role of opposition. The party which has not won the election, those who are in minority, they are political minority, they sit in the opposition and they also play the role of opposition, and they criticize the policies and programs at every step of the ruling party. Ruling party ke sabhi policies aur programs ko par pani nazar rakhti hai opposition, aur hamesha hi uska criticism karne ka dhyan rakhti hai. For example, jaise ki abhi kisan फार्मर्स की कुछ लॉज के ऑर्डिनेंसेस पास हुए हैं पार्लियामेंट में, तो कांग्रेस, वही कांग्रेस जो 2014 से पहले इन लॉज को पास करने की बात कर रही थी, वही कांग्रेस अब इसकी अपोजिशन कर रही है, इसको अपोज कर रही है, बिकॉज दे आर बीइंग स्टार्टेड बाय बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट अंडर NDA, नेशनल डेमोक्रेटिक अलायंस. Moreover, these political parties, they shape the public opinion. लोगों के opinion को shape करने का भी काम करती हैं. वो किसी ना किसी topic पर लोगों की राय अपने पक्ष में करने का पूरा प्रयास करती हैं. These parties always provide people's access to government machinery and welfare schemes implemented by the government. लोगों की गवर्नमेंट मशीनरी तक एसेस भी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज के थ्रू ही लोग गवर्नमेंट मशीनरी तक पहुंच सकते हैं, और जो अलग अलग वेलफेयर स्कीम्स हैं उन तक लोग आसानी से पहुंच सकते हैं थ्रू पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज ओनली। नाउ पार्टी सिस्टम किस तरह का है, इस चैप्टर में हमने जो फोर पॉइंट्स पढ़ने हैं, फोर टॉपिक्स पढ़ने हैं, दैट आर पार्टीज एंड द पार्टी सिस्टम इन इंडिया, कांग्रेस पार्टी सिस्टम, बाई पार्टी सिस्टम, मल्टी पार्टी एंड कॉलिशन सिस्टम। सो दीज आर ऑल टॉपिक्स विच वी हैव टू स्टडी। एंड वॉट इज स्पेशल इन द पार्टी सिस्टम इन इंडिया, एक किसी देश में मल्टी पार्टी सिस्टम है, बाई पार्टी सिस्टम है या सिंगल पार्टी सिस्टम है, इट इज़ मेनली डिपेंडेंट ऑन द डाइवर्सिटी, बिकॉज इंडिया इज फुल ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी एट रीजनल लेवल, स्टेट लेवल एंड नेशनल लेवल डाइवर्सिटी कैन बी सीन। सो दैट इज वाई मल्टी पार्टी सिस्टम हैज़ बीन अडोप्टेड, इट इज़ देयर इन इंडिया। Political parties, they are classified in three categories like national, state and regional level. Due to various diversities only, multi-party system is present in India. And the status to a party is accorded by the Election Commission of India and that is reviewed occasionally. And all the parties, they have to get themselves registered with the Election Commission. A special symbol or a unique election symbol is given to every registered party by the Election Commission. According to the latest information as published by Election Commission of India, in India we have parties which are registered, 2,598 parties. Among them, 8 are national parties, 52 are state parties, and 2,538 parties are unrecognized parties in India. So, we will see that which party can be given the status of national party. According to the Election Commission of India, a party can be given the acknowledgement, it can be accorded as a national party if it has won 2% of the seats of the Lok Sabha from at least three different states. For example, Lok Sabha is 543 members, 543 seats are there in your Lok Sabha, and its 2% is about 11 point something. Means 11 seats a party has to win in three different states, like 11 from Punjab, 11 from Gujarat and 11 from Tamil Nadu, three different states. The second condition, second criteria to become a national party is that in general election the party must win 6% of the votes and win at least 4 Lok Sabha seats L as well. Seats or votes ka aapko pata hoga, seats Lok Sabha ki hoti hain and votes means total valid votes which were cast. Total valid votes which were cast, उसका 6% अगर एक पार्टी acquire कर लेती है, win कर लेती है और साथ में 4 लोकसभा seats में जीत जाती है, in that situation, that particular party can be accorded as a national party of India. And if a party is recognized at a state level party in 4 or more states, then in that condition also that particular party can be acknowledged as a national party. We have 8 recognized national parties in India. Among them, the first one is Indian National Congress, that is Indian National Congress, Bharatiya Janata Party, Bahujan Samaj Party, Communist Party of India, Communist Party of India Marxist, the NCP, Nationalist Congress Party, All India Trinamool Congress, National People's Party, which is a newly and the latest party led by P.A. Sangma in Meghalaya, and it was recognized as a national party in June 2019. Means in last year only it was recognized as a national party of India. If we see the national parties of India, if you have to gather more and more information, you have to go to the pages of these national political parties. The first party is Indian National Congress. It is having the symbol of hand. It is the oldest party, and it is the same party which was established, which was founded by A.O. Hume in 1885. Since today, it has faced many splits. Many parties, they owe their origin from this Indian National Congress. The next party is your BJP, having the symbol of lotus. It is a ruling party under the coalition of NDA, National Democratic Alliance. Its parent party is Janasangh, whose founder was Shyama Prasad Mukherjee. And the third party is NCP, Nationalist Congress Party, founded by Sharad Pawar in 1999. And in Maharashtra politics, it is playing an important role. Nationalist Congress Party. Sharad Pawar, he was again on the seat of Defense Minister and Agriculture Minister of India. And when the thing on one question, this NCP became separated from Congress, that when Sonia Gandhi, he was declared as the president, at that moment Sharad Pawar, he opposed on this point, that a person from Italian origin should not be given the seat of president of the Congress. On this issue, he was expelled from the party and he made a separate party in 1999. And after some time, these differences and all these issues were sorted out, and Nationalist Congress Party, it became a constituent of UPA government led by Congress. United Progressive Alliance ki ek constituent baad mein ban gayi thi. जितने भी डिफरेंसेस थे वो बाद में सॉर्ट आउट हो गए थे. द फोर्थ पार्टी दैट इज योर ऑल इंडिया तृणमूल कांग्रेस. ममता बनर्जी वेस्ट बंगाल की पार्टी है. दिस पार्टी इज हैविंग अ स्ट्रॉन्ग होल्ड इन वेस्ट बंगाल. इन 2011 सीपीआई कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी ऑफ इंडिया के रूल को, लंबे रूल को एंड करने का क्रेडिट ममता बनर्जी की इस पार्टी ऑल इंडिया तृणमूल कांग्रेस को जाता है. दिस इज द सेम पार्टी विच हैज़ कम फ्रॉम कांग्रेस एंड एट प्रेजेंट फ्रॉम 2011 दिस पार्टी इज सर्विंग फॉर द सेकेंड टर्म इन वेस्ट बंगाल. ये अपनी दूसरी पारी खेल रही है वेस्ट बंगाल में. इससे पहले सीपीआई का रूल था, कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी ऑफ इंडिया का रूल था. नाउ नेक्स्ट नेशनल पार्टी इज सीपीआई. सीपीआई अकॉर्डिंग टू द वेरियस रिकॉर्ड्स, इट्स फाउंडिंग ईयर इज 1925. इट फेस्ड ब्रेकअप इन 1964 ड्यू टू आइडियोलॉजिकल डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन यूएसएसआर एंड चाइना, दैट टू होम साइड इंडिया हैज टू गो. एंड आफ्टर दैट CPIM, when breakup happened, CPIM, it took birth, and these are the two separate parties. Both are having the status of national party. Next is the elephant symbol. You know very well, this is the party of Mayawati. And it was founded in 1984 under the leadership of Kanshiram. Kanshiram, he gave us the logic that scheduled caste, tribes and other backward classes, they form the Bahujan Samaj. They are forming the majority of the population. And according to the reports of the Mandal Commission, special status was given to these scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. And they also gave the slogan of बहुजन हिताय बहुजन सुखाय. नेक्स्ट इज योर मेघालय नेशनल पीपल्स पार्टी इन मेघालय एंड दिस पार्टी National People's Party in Meghalaya, and this party was led by P.A. Sangma. Actually, what happened when there was a split in Congress under the leadership of Sharad Pawar, P.A. Sangma also joined him. He left in 2002. He also left Nationalist Congress Party under the leadership of Sharad Pawar. And he participated, the issue was this, that he participated, he applied for the presidential election, he stood in the presidential election, and Nationalist Congress Party told him to withdraw his name. So that is why these were the issues which were there between him and Sharad Pawar. Nationalist Congress Party told them to withdraw, told him to withdraw his name, that is why he made a separate party that was he left NCP in 2002, and recently in June 2019 in Meghalaya, P.A. Sangma, he made National People's Party, a new party which has the party was made earlier, but in June 2019 it has got the status of a national party. This is all with today's point. Thank you. Have a nice day.